The gray whale that we have on the coast here was called the devilfish by the Japanese whalers because it fights back. It was unlike some whales that allow themselves to be killed without fighting back, the gray whale will try to sink you. If you don't bother it, they're quite friendly, but if their offspring are killed or their associates are killed, they'll take revenge. A few years ago, I was down in Bunnell, California at Scammon'S Lagoon, which is a big gray whale breeding ground.
And a real medical scumbag, a doctor who was a kind of a wheeler dealer politician type, had gotten a program to harpoon gray whales and get electrocardiograms from them for some sort of hocus pocus, phony medical reason. And he was secretly working with people interested in whaling and to use this as a kind of a sneaky way of opening up the season on gray whales, which under protection had increased to several thousand. And he'd gone in there, Scammon's Lagoon, and was harpooning these whales right in their nursery. I saw him harpoon, he was anesthetizing them, which always killed the whales because whales don't breathe when they're unconscious. I saw him harpoon and anesthetize a mother whale, which left her calf starved to death. And he was going great guns. Fortunately, some people wrote letters and he lost his backing. But at the time I was down there, there were three executives from the salt works, which is nearby, who were out on a boating trip on the lagoon to see the whales. And a whale came up and whacked their boat so hard that one of these guys had his binoculars driven right back through his head. And this was something that hadn't happened for years. I mean, these whales were very angry. They knew they were being attacked. And they found this group of three humans in a boat, and one of them took revenge. I think that's quite understandable.
It's too bad the good doctor couldn't have been in the boat.